Hello, everybody, and welcome! It's the finale of Banjo-Tooie. Hi, guys. My name is Josh Jepson, by the way, in case you were unaware. In case this is your first time ever seeing my channel, the finale of Banjo-Tooie. Well done, you made it. We only have one more thing to do, and that's unlock the final areas and go and fight Grunty at the end of the game. And I'm very excited. And I wanted to say real quick, too, like, you know, I did a Let's Play of Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie way very long ago, and it's been in my, you know, interest, you know, something I've been interested in doing for a while is remaking these Let's Plays in a classic style Let's Play definitive version kind of deal. So I wanted to thank you for being here for that, and I appreciate each and every one of you. Let's go ahead and not do the middle pieces first. This is the plague on my psyche. Every time I see these puzzles, I'm like, I gotta do the middle first. I don't have to do the middle first. In fact, it's much easier if I don't. So I won't. Here we go. Corner. Honestly, corners first, really, if you think about it, is the best way to go. But here I am. I'm gonna do the middle pieces. That's not even right. Okay. Dang. Dang. Now we can do the middle pieces. Look at how easy this is. Look at how much easier it is to do the middle piece. Is Banjo long here? I'm sorry, I'm mesmerized by this pre-recorded video that we're building. Banjo feels really long here. Is this elongated, like, vertically? I wonder if that's because it's fitting into a 4x3 frame, but this game, this particular version of the game, is 16x9, so they have to squash it vertically, or horizontally, I guess. Wild. All right. The power of the crystal jiggy compels us. Technically, you can unlock this at 55 jiggies. Like, you could do this part of the game at 55 jiggies. There's a whole 35 more jiggies to get in the game at that point. Like, we had 55 jiggies forever ago. And yet here we are, just barely unlocking, or just now unlocking Cauldron Key. Whoa. Dude, every time the crystal jiggy goes off, my controller vibrates like mad. You are indeed the chosen one. You also have enough jiggies to attempt Jiggy Wiggy's challenge 10. That's right, there is one more challenge. For 70 jiggies, which is, by the way, the most jiggies you need to beat the game. Much, much lower bar than the original Banjo-Kazooie. Like, you need almost all of the jiggies and all of the notes to beat the original Banjo-Kazooie. This game's a little more forgiving in that respect. Jiggy Wiggy's Challenge 10, where is this mysterious place? And also, there are no pieces already filled in for this one, so we just kind of have to start somewhere, you know? And also, it's very gray. Like, they made this one extra hard. I think there's a bonus challenge after this, too. But none of them are anywhere near as difficult as the end of Banjo-Kazooie, where you can do the bottles bonus challenges. None of these challenges are anywhere near as difficult as those ones. And I kind of wish that they did like a few more after post-game that let you, you know, like how you can flip them and stuff in the original. I think there's one challenge that lets you do that. Where does this go? Here? Cool. This one's got Banjo in it. This one's got his feet for free. This one also has his feet. Oh my God. So much Banjo feet. We're gonna defeat Grunty. We're gonna take her feet off. No, we're not. We're not gonna take her feet off. We might take her head off. Anyway, the power of the crystal jiggy compels me! Dude, Cauldron Keep is so menacing. That's one thing I do love about this game is the scale of it. Like, I feel like the scale of Banjo-Kazooie is so hard to gauge because all of it takes place inside Grunty's layer, which is big in it of itself, but the outside scale of everything is so big in this game. You have proved yourself most worthy by opening all the doors. A super special challenge now awaits, one that has no reward, yet is the greatest test of all. We will do that in a future bonus video. There's at least one bonus video that I want to make where I show off the extra cheats that I, the special cheat, the hidden cheats, and also do that last challenge. And if there's anything else that you want me to show in a bonus video, please let me know in the comments down below. And while you're down there, you might as well subscribe and like the video. Like, it's like one swoop, you know? All right, let's do it. Let's head over to Quagmire once more. Giggity giggity goo. Oh wait, I'm gonna need like sticky boots. Hold on, where are the sticky boots? I think they're all the way on the other end of this pipe, actually. One final puzzle before we get to enter the last area. Yeah, you thought. Yeah, you thought. Dude, honestly, the end game is gonna be so easy given how much health I have and also the fact that I have honey back turned on. I should honestly probably turn honey back off for the final boss. I'm not gonna, but I should. I really should do that. This is maybe one of the greatest end games in all of gaming. Like, the original Banjo-Kazooie, it rivals it. Like, I think it's all, they're all very good. Here we go. Welcome to Cauldron Keep. The most ominous, scary entrance to a final boss ever. We have to scale this tower now. But first, we have to figure out how to get in there. Oh, wait, before we do any of this. Here, I'll open this first and then we can. I don't know why I did that when I'm supposed to do this. Not that. I guess that would work too, but. God, it's so good. I wish I could remember my first playthrough of this game. Because I remember not really liking this game as much as the original when I first played it when I was a kid. Like, I enjoyed it, and I was, like, really happy to see that there was more Banjo happening, but I don't remember my first playthrough very well. We're infiltrating the Cauldron Keep Tower. But, of course, there's laser beams. Look, it hurts. There's something, like, really special about knowing that I'm basically invincible. Hey! I have all of you! How many eggs do you eat, bro? What the hell? Oh, you're just gonna pretend again? See ya. How many freaking eggs, dude? Here, I'm gonna switch to the fire egg since I have unlimited of those. All right, here we go. Let's scale the tower. Ooh, the gatehouse.
Hey, Kazooie, there doesn't appear to be anyone in here.
Oh, yes, there is. The music's changed. Every time that happens, we always end up in a fight.
Yarr, yo-ho-ho, Plungo must defend Mistress Grunty's boat. Yarr, pirate Captain Klungo here.
First mate Klungo, he's not a captain. Klungo's kind of a beta.
Yes, Klungo means no. Must win this time or Mistress feed me to monster.
Jesus Christ. Dude, how many times is it gonna take you to just give up? Like, look at how beat up this mother trucker is. Grunty doesn't have any health care provided to her employees. Oh, this is the hardest one too. Because you can't tell. It's like whichever one leaves last is the correct one. Yeah, that was the wrong one. I wasn't paying attention. I looked away. I looked at the camera. Stop being so beautiful. I keep looking at you. See, I did it again! He split up and I looked at the camera! God! Did I do it? I didn't even hear the correct sound. Okay, so whichever one leaves last. So it's this one. This was the correct one. There we go. Dude, he doesn't even get any new attacks. He's just like, here's my new potion that I'm trying out. Like, he's just a nerd. Here's my new potion.
I'm gonna split up and run around.
This is the final boss, by the way. Grunty isn't even the final boss. Who would have guessed? Wow, we did it! Credits roll! Show me the character parade!
Cluggo noticed something happening after fights with Barret Bird.
And that is? Cluggo gets less and less handsome. No, Mrs. Cluggo won't want me anymore.
Wait, Mrs. Cluggo? He's married? We've never seen Mrs. Cluggo.
Future prospects not good with Mistress Grunty. No chance of promotion. No days off. No pay. Cluggo go find easy desk job. Maybe make stupid games.
Oh, man. I hate to break it to you, Cluggo, but it's not an easy game. Game development is not an easy job in the year of our Lord 2024. Was it ever? Good luck making a video game, dude. I believe in you. I'm glad he's finally realizing the error of his ways. Following Grunty. Welcome to the Tower of Tragedy! It's a quiz show! Wouldn't be a Banjo-Kazooie game without a quiz show.
Thank you, thank you. I'm Grunty, your host, and I may welcome you to my Tower of the Tragedy quiz. Let me run through the rules for you all. Here are three rounds of general knowledge questions. And the person with the lowest score at the end of each round will be eliminated. Correct answers score 2 points, with 1 point being awarded if it was a second guess.
I love how they just throw you into the deep end with this. Also, by the way, this quiz, hella broken. And I don't know if it's just broken on the Xbox version. I think it's also broken in the original. There are some times where your opponents, her sisters, will answer ahead of time. Watch carefully. They will answer before the question's even on screen. It's my gorgeous slim sister, Mangella.
And on the right, we have my lovelier, shapely sister, Blabalda. And in the middle, just some loser bear called Banjo.
Wait, it doesn't even acknowledge Kazooie, dude. Kazooie's like the star of the show. Who is the mighty Mayan god of shooting? See ya. How do I answer? Buzz in. Marzipan! Just pay attention to the wrong answers. They're all very funny. What shape is the TV in the game selection screen? Didn't even get a chance to read it. That's okay. I'm gonna get this second point. It's honeycomb shaped, obviously. I'm a bear. What shape do you think my TV would be? What is at the top of Grunty's Industries chimney stack? It's an empty honeycomb. I almost said Jinjo, but that's in inside. Take a look at this scene. Do you know what's on my screen? It's two wave racers in who ran? It's Captain Blubber ran that. See, sometimes I have to answer, like, buzz in before the question even goes. Otherwise, I'm not gonna score. Jolly Roger's water pipeline. What's a slagoon? Oh, that's in Grunty's Industries. Okay. Take a look at this scene. So many of these. Sometimes they'll buzz in like mid. What? That's the same thing. They're gonna ask me something different about this. Where is it? Barrels. There are four of them. Shit. Sometimes you have to count stuff on the screen. You have no idea. Wait, barrels plus wave racers? I thought there was three barrels. Screw you, what a dumb question. Air conditioning boiler generator plant is not in the thing, because why would you use electricity? It's too environmentally friendly. What color are normal blue eggs? Normal blue eggs, what color are they? Oh, talking about, what's his face? From 1986? Four. The year that Rareware came into foundation? That's unfortunate. That's okay, these guys suck anyway. For some reason, I thought it was like 2 years later. I guess Saber Wolf was one of their first games. They said this is Grunty's Industries. This is where Welder is. You could actually see Welder's head down there. That's hilarious. Who lurks in here? It's Weldar. Screwer. Screwer? I hardly knew her. Who is Canary Mary and Glitter Gulch Mine? A bitch. Crazy bird woman. What object is the alien girl holding? I know this one, but you didn't let me do it. Thicko. Okay, you holding a hairbrush. Really? It's a mirror? One of them is holding a Jinjo. So that's what I thought it was going to be. Anyway, at the end of round one, Mingella sucks. Goodbye, Mingella. Mingella DeVille, Mingella DeVille. Which gets squished? Which? They should have changed that to which gets squished. Switch. Who lives in Honeybee's hive? Guess who it is? It's Honeybee. Some of these questions literally have the answer in them. Why couldn't Chuffy the train travel the ice side? Because it was too hot. Let's look at the screen. Do you know where you have been? 1, 2, 3. That's the Dodgem Dome in 7. I don't even know what the question is. How many glowing white lights are there on the floor? Are you shitting me? 8? Ah! I'm not counting shit, Grunty. What? What are you talking about? Stealing his eggs. Jesus. See, this is what I'm saying. They cheat, man. Which area does not exist in Jolly Roger's Lagoon? Anchor repair shed. You know it all. I know it when you let me read the question. Okay, it's drunk. Captain Black Eye. The picture is Treasure Cove. Where is this seasick pirate? In Jolly Jolly's Bar and Bistro? Drive through McJolly's! It's just Jolly's. No! I wanted to... Do not... No! I wanted the Seaman Surprise! Are you just gonna ask me where it is? Yeah, it's the Dodgem Games. Last time you made me count, I was worried. It's kickball, baby. See, this goes by so fast. Which Banjo-Kazooie character guarded the big top 10 traits? It was Konga the Gorilla. Could you imagine? Jelly Castle is red. Oh, what color? It's strawberry flavored. I thought you asked what color it was. Strawberry color. That question was how many points the player starts with in the final round of this game, which you wouldn't know. And they cheated. Okay, that's Terry. Harry! Harry, Terry, and Larry, the Three Stooges. Jolly Roger's partner was Mary Maggie. The oil pipeline in Grunty's Industries waste disposal plant comes from where? Hailfire pants. That's okay, I'm way ahead in points. I'm gonna win this round. Let's look at the screen. That's fish in Fireside. Boggy Bear? Boggy Bear eats that. Eats that. All right, Blobelda. I'm pretty sure that it must be programmed for them to cheat, to be honest. Like, that's a very, very obvious thing. So I like to get the jump on them and try to cheat, too. The final round, make it harder. I won't show you the answers unless you buzz in. That's not going to make it harder for me. If anything, it's going to make it easier. How many passes do I get? Do I lose points if I pass? So I have to beat a certain number of points. Banjo lost or Grunty squashed? On top of a planet. What does Humbawamba change Banjo to in Witchy World? It's A van. I almost said washing machine because my brain saw washing machine. I was like, that's got to be it. What spell does Mumbo perform at Grunty's Industries? It's EMP. Was the name of the Indian who changes? Oh, you just talked about her. Waka Naka. Her name was Waka Waka. The color of Boggy the Polar Bear's bed spread in Hailfire Peak's lagoon. Oh, igloo. I don't know why to say red and blue. Nah. I couldn't remember that one. Which of these areas is not found in Mayhem Temple? Dark Gun Fields. Where does King Jingling live? In a throne room. In a shed. He lives in a shed. Which item isn't found in an ice cube in Hailfire Peaks? Ooh, that's a great question. Treble Clef. The Treble Clef was in an ice cube? What label could you find? Mangella's Milk, Jolly's Juice. Jolly's Juice. Wumba's Water? Whoa. What is Witchwell's strength-based attraction called? It's called the Cactus of Peril. Strength. What is the unusual about Mumble Skull and Grunty's Industries? It's got metal on it. One more. What does Boggy the Polar Bear want to eat in Hailfire Peaks? It's a fish. Love how they put Lord Rufak back next to the fish. Sunlight. Okay, we're on a roll now. Which of the banjo only moves is activated by holding R, T, and pressing the right stick up? Oh, I know this one. It's the sack pack. I just used that. How many egg nests are there in Heggie's egg shed? Three? Not that we need to use them at all. Learned in Jolly Roger's Lagoon. Talon Torpedo? Talon Torpedo. Sometimes they try to trick you. What's the piggy cage call trying to do? He's trying to take pictures of the wall. Film the paintings. With a Game Boy camera. What is the name of World 3? Witchy World, baby. Baby baboom. Time for a nasty one number of questions. Is this on my list? 73. Really? No, see that one's bullshit, because you wouldn't know what number it is on her list ever. There's no way to know that. I didn't read the question at all, but that's okay. I didn't need that one. That's the end of the final round. A useless score that, huh? What's wrong with the scoring system? It must be broken. You can't have got that many points. No, 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 no. I declare the win invalid due to faulty equipment.
Oh, dear. So what happens now?
I don't know. Any ideas?
Well, you could escape in a cowardly fashion like in Banjo-Kazooie before we kick your bony butt.
Yes, I could. Thanks, Birdrain. Fortunately, I've built a rocket into my booth for this very reason. I'll be waiting for you at the top like last time. But this time, you'll be the ones taking the fall!
I love how she's got a rocket built into the bottom of her thing. All right, the gun chamber's open.
Right, come on, Kazooie. Let's go and see where that door that's just open leads.
Do you reckon that's the end of the game?
I doubt it. We've not had the credits yet.
That's true.
Okay, let's go.
I love how the set starts falling apart afterwards.
All right, here it is. It's credits time, baby, in memory of Chris Mullinder. Aw,
rest in peace. I can skip this, should I? Nah, I won't. I'll let it play out. This is important. Banjo-Tooie was brought to you by viewers like you.
Yay.
No, this gives me an opportunity to talk about the game a little bit. First of all, shout out to all the people who made this game in the end of the 1900s. Okay, the game released in 2000, so like they were developing it for a couple years there. Shout out to the original Rareware team behind all this stuff. And also, like, it's very nice of them to still be acknowledging Banjo over there at both Rare and at Microsoft, even though I know that the Rare team that are working on, like, new games like Sea of Thieves and their other new game that may or may not ever release, Everwild, I don't think that they want to make a new Banjo game. But they know that people love Banjo, and they are releasing a lot of new merch for Banjo, and I love seeing all that stuff. So, like, I'm very happy that the characters are still getting love. You know, their inclusion in Smash Brothers was such a huge moment for me. That was, like, as a Banjo fan, one of the biggest things that could have ever happened to my favorite characters. So it's like, it's really cool that they're around, man. You know, like, it's crazy because, like, you know, I thought when Banjo-Tooie came out and they were like, oh, Banjo-Threeie is going to happen. Like, I was waiting with bated breath for years for a Banjo-Threeie. And you bet your ass that I was all over, one, the GBA game that came out, and two, Nuts and Bolts. I loved Nuts and Bolts. I was all for it. I saw that first trailer and I was like, oh, Banjo-Threeie is finally happening. And then the official reveal with cars and building and stuff, I was like, that's different. But I was on board, you know? My first thought was like, when I first saw the Nuts and Bolts trailer, I was like, this kind of reminds me a little bit of Ratchet and Clank. It's kind of got like this sort of futuristic vibe to it, and I'm here for it. So I was on board right from that first trailer. And that's a game that I'd like to cover on the channel at some point, but I want to do it right. I want to really, really go into detail of, you know, the things that I like and dislike about that game, and do like a proper, maybe even scripted series about Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, because I feel like that game gets so much shit. And that game, especially in the year 2024, you realize if you play that game, it is a way ahead of its time. At the time, you know, people were all about like Call of Duty and Halo and like first person shooters. Like that was the big, was like the very gray first person shooter multiplayer game. And so like a lot of people give Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts shit for like having an opening scene where one of the characters mentions how gamers today don't want to play platformers, blah, 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 blah. And that was true at the time. And it was a commentary on the games industry and not like a diss against the fans. So I think that that's an invalid argument. Here I am talking about Nuts and Bolts so much in the Banjo-Tooie credits, but you know, I mean, that's the acceptable next thought pattern, right? And it won't be a while. It will be a while before I cover Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. Like, don't expect that right away. Anyway, Tooie, fantastic game. I love the backtracking stuff. I think that's fine. You know, Banjo-Tooie is my favorite Metroidvania. Is a great joke that I subscribe to. It's just very big and dark compared to the first game. I think the vibe is very different, and I think that's what sets it apart. You know, Banjo-Tooie is a very different game while still maintaining all of the things that make it a Banjo game. And that's something that I think that Nuts and Bolts actually failed at, which was they didn't keep the vibe of the original games. They did take it in a completely different direction, and I think that, the reason for that was they were expecting to get a new audience for those games. But if they leaned into what made the original special for a new game, I think they would have actually like pulled a bunch of people from Nintendo over to Xbox. I was one of those people, right? Like I was like, I have to get an Xbox now because Banjo's gonna be there. And I mean, I got an Xbox for Halo. Let's be real here. My friend convinced me to play Halo with him. But then, you know, it was easy to make that decision knowing that whatever we got for Banjo-Threeie would eventually be on the Xbox. So I was like, all right, I'm all in. Let's get used to Xbox. And so like them re-releasing these games on the Xbox, them re-releasing them again in Rare Replay, and then releasing the original Banjo game on Nintendo Switch Online, I'm so glad that these games remain around. You know, these games could have easily been, you know, shoved aside and forgotten about, but they weren't. And you bet your ass, if this game, Banjo-Tooie, ever comes to Nintendo Switch Online, which it absolutely has to, come on, Diddy Kong Racing also, that I absolutely will play it again. I don't know if I'll do another Let's Play of it, but I'll do like I'll stream it for sure. Because, you know, the more people that can experience these games, the better. And I've gotten so many comments over the last, like, however long Banjo-Kazooie's been on NSO, like a year longer. It's probably been longer. I don't even know when it happened. I've gotten so many comments from people saying that they are playing that game for the first time because it's available on a console that they actually own. You know, it was really hard to recommend Banjo-Kazooie to people for a long time because they would have had to pick up an Xbox 360 or an Xbox One or an Xbox Series X. And so my recommendation was always just emulate it. Just get the original and emulate it. But now it's accessible. And I love that. Go play Banjo-Kazooie if you haven't played it. And then, like, go on Twitter and be like, where's Banjo-Tooie? And then, like, just do that over and over again until they add it to NSO. Well, I mean, honestly, with the amount of Rare games that have been coming to the Nintendo Switch Online service, I do think that eventually we will get all of those classic Rare games on the N64. It's just that they drip feed us N64 games. You know, and I think that they will continue to add NSO stuff into the Switch 2's lifespan, too. So that could be a thing. Here we are. Here we are. Well, don't just stand there. There's still time to save my brother and Jingling by reversing the gun settings.
But there's no instructions.
Banjo, there's two buttons, bro. No problem. I'll just press a few buttons. See what happens. I guess there's some buttons down on the console in front. Beep, boop, beep, boop.
No, I...
There, that should do it. You crazy feathered punk! Anything might happen! Uh-oh. I love how it's aimed in, like the reticle's aimed in on a headshot. I wonder what will hit down there. This is so cool, though. What a neat part of a game. Boom! Headshot! 360 no-scope! I believe you owe me an apology, dumb jars. Not a chance. Why is Jam Jar such an asshole? Oh, thanks, guys. Life's not much fun as a zombie. He's back! The lad!
Bottle's next, then, Kazooie. He's been lifeless for quite a while, so I think you'd better turn it up to full power.
Not until Soldier Boy apologize. Sorry, Kazooie. Aww. Thank you. Oh, don't miss. Don't miss. You're gonna miss. You're gonna bring his hand back to life, dude. Just his hand. What a magical moment. Bottles has been dead for so long. Look at him undulate. Bottles!
Oh no, look at the time. I'm really late for dinner. Mrs. B will kill me.
Good joke, that's a good joke.
I don't care how burnt it is. You're still eating it.
She burned it on purpose.
It's not my fault. Oh, the witch killed me, and I've only just come back to life.
Likely story.
Yes. I'm sure you have, dear.
Oop, my game is literally going into sleep mode because I've been sitting here watching this cutscene for so long.
Oh, goodness. Who might you two be?
Yo, I'm King Jingling. And this fine fellow is Klungo.
Baron Bird freed Klungo from evil clutches of Mistress.
They saved me from an eternity as one of the undead. Pog. Hell yeah, bro. Dude, Jingling would totally be like a cringy Twitch streamer, like me. He would.
Oh, lovely. I'll make us some nice scones. Oh, but where's Banjo? He's the real hero.
And Kazooie?
Mistress escaped, so brave bear and bird going after her.
Aw, he called us brave. They'll join us later. But now let's party! Hell yeah! Chug, 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 chug!
This must be the end now. We've had the credits, and everyone's all right.
What about Grunty? Oh. I think we ought to just take a quick look at the top of the tower.
Oh, but there's no way up there.
Nice try, Banjo. But I reckon that opening below the gun over there probably leads up.
I was hoping you hadn't seen that.
Aw, Banjo, don't be scared, buddy. We have honey back turned on. Don't be scared, buddy. Everything's a-okay. You're gonna be fine. Speaking of fine, look at this fine piece of ass. It's Dingpot. It's Dingpot.
Oh, why, hello there, Mr. Banjo. I'm Dingpot, remember me?
No, not really.
I helped you at the end of Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh yeah, it's old Stinkpot.
Oh, you're so cruel. Hey, why not jump inside for a nice dingy bonus?
Well, sweet, I've only just got my feathers cleaned from last time. Okay, so Dingpot is how you refill on your feathers and eggs and stuff, which is useful before the final boss.
Speaking of the final boss,
let's head up. I do have one more thing I want to show off, though, in the game before we do the final boss. Dude, this is so scary. I love how this is just straight up connected to that area, too. So, like, you can just fall off the side here and go back down. Okay, so before we do any of that, let's head back because I want to show off something. And, like, honestly, if you didn't know about this already, there's no reason to ever do this, but it's such a neat little detail, and I would be remiss if I didn't show this off. So back here in Jinjo Village, just across from Jingling's palace, is Bottles' house. The door's closed, but
sorry guys, but you can't come to the party until the witch's history.
Yes, Bear and Bird must go back to castle and bash Mistress.
Hurry along, Banjo dear. I'll save you one of my scones.
Dude, they're partying without us, and we're the heroes of the story, and we save their asses.
You're not coming in. Please go and defeat the witch in her castle. There's a good bear.
Yes. Now pass Cluggo another scone.
This is so good. I just love their interactions. Bro, I do feel sad, though. I'm outside the party, like, All right. Dude, honestly, Party at Bottles, best song in the whole series. I want to party with them. I guess we better go defeat Grunty quick so that the food doesn't get cold and they don't run out of drinks. Let's hurry up. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Man, I can't believe I forgot to activate this. But like over here to the left, the Cauldron Keep entrance is this little button that lets you get up a little bit easier. You just use this jump pad to climb up instead of using the boots. And I'll never need to use that because we're about to finish the game. There's exactly one chance for me to use that. And I've squandered it. Such is the life. Some people call that the Let's Player's Curse. All right. Honeyback, on. Homing Eggs, on. Dragon Kazooie, on. Let's do this thing.
Oh, looks like there's no one here. We should go home now.
Wow, It's one heck of a view from up here.
Sure is. But doesn't it seem strange that Gruntilda isn't up here to meet us?
Obviously chickened out. I've enjoyed our adventure, but let's get back to the card game.
About that. Kazooie?
There's a slight issue with that. Hagwon, monstrous mechanical mud muncher. I've always loved the alliteration there. Banjo?
No. Look at the size of that.
I'm sure it wasn't that big before.
That's what she said.
But now what does Grunty say? This is so ominous. What a great final boss.
Finally, after 2 years, revenge time.
Don't bet on it, Bone Brain.
We'll see, little bird, we'll see.
I kind of wish she went back to rhyming during the final boss because her sisters are like dead. It's like, there's nobody to be annoyed by her rhyming. I love the effect on these lasers. Like the slight flicker and everything. Because they're so thin, you know? Like, I feel like so many, like, classic game lasers are just, like, thick boys, you know?
Thought the quiz was over, did you? Think again. I've still got quite a few question cards up my sleeve. Answer correctly, and maybe I'll go a little easier on you.
What's the name of my beautiful life-sucking gun? It's William. Dave. It's Bob. B.O.B. Battery-operated boyfriend.
That's correct. I'll only use my slower attack now.
I love how she, like, actively holds back. Like, are they friends? I feel like this is Grunty's way of saying, hey, we can be friends, bro. We can be friends. It's okay. How many damages is does the grenade egg take? The grenade egg does 3 points of damage, so I'm going to use grenade eggs for the most part. Like, she's so slow. Oh, wait. I didn't get it all the way down. I had time. I didn't realize she was gonna like, never mind. I went a little slow there. Shouldn't have done that. Oops, didn't mean to answer that immediately. Now we gotta fight the faster attack. Good thing I only need to do 1 point of damage before her next phase. Dude, also homing eggs really aren't helping that much.
1-0 to the pesky bear.
More lasers are required. Ah. How do I switch them all on? This one?
Lovely. Here we go again.
Aw, shit. Here we go again. This is great. There's also, like, so much opportunity for Honeyback to operate. Like, you could never lose this fight.
What do the Dragon Brothers on Hailfire Peaks want?
Pizza.
Dude, we're just gonna keep doing this. Man, I really wish you could get like a few extra hits in there, but you're basically confined to do 10 points of damage for each phase.
Plenty more tricks left in this beauty. Activate the mortar cannon. Bombs away.
Why doesn't she just go all out? Like, just activate all the things immediately and destroy the shit out of Banjo-Kazooie. You know? Serpentine! 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 There is, like, no sense of danger here. Oh my god, that's so messed up! You killed them! You murderer! You terrible person, you! I hate you, Gruntilda the Witch! Grunty Winky Bunyan! How dare you! You killed them! We never did get to bring the Grey Jinjo family back. Isn't that so sad? Whoa, double the mortar, double your fun, baby. God, that explosion is so loud. But only in my left ear because of stereo audio. Before you met me, which boss character had the most energy? What? Lord Wu Fakfak? Uh-oh. Is it Old King Cole? I think it's Old King Cole. But honestly, I don't even know. It's probably like the one that's latest in the game, so it's probably Terry, I guess.
Fetch the cannons back in. Open the exhaust port.
Oh, you want to know something that makes this final boss fight so much harder on the original version of this game? So you know how I'm strafing and aiming up? You cannot strafe and aim up at the same time. If you strafed in the original game in first person mode, you would aim, it would like reset your aim to forward. Yeah. So you had to strafe, aim, shoot, strafe, aim, shoot. You couldn't aim and then just keep strafing, you know? So like that makes it honestly like 10 times harder. What color were King Jingling's slippers? Oh. Thank you. Gotta be honest, did not look at his slippers ever. Not once did I look at his slippers. Oops, I'm running into the lasers now. Dude. It's hard to see from this angle. Like, some angles, because it's a 2D texture of the lasers. Oh yeah, we gotta do this now. Adds a little extra fun part to this, where you have to use the Clockwork Kazooie to blow up the inside. Look, it's the Bigga Bazza! We've met Bazza, but have you met Bigga Bazza? Bigga Bazza, faster, stronger. What's that smell? Oh, sorry, I farted. Ouch. Rude. Dude, honestly, I feel like just taking a bunch of hits just to make this... make the sense of danger so much higher. I should have turned off Honey Mac just to preserve the sense of danger. I'm sorry. It does feel like cheating, doesn't it? That's okay. All's fair in love and war, baby. All's fair in love and war. What is the total number of legs on all of Humba Wumba's transformations? 14. I don't know. Dude, many of them don't have legs. To be honest, like the washing machine and the snowball. Like, it's Stony has two legs. You know, the bee has what, four legs? Did it count limbs? Was it counting arms too? Or was it just legs, did it say? I genuinely don't remember. All right, Bigga Bazza, harder, faster.
Oh no, we're losing power. No, don't stop, Mr. Drill. My lovely lasers, my lovely lady lasers.
Right, that's it. I've had enough. We fight to the death. All right, here we go. This is it. Unleash. Actually, this is a great part to use the grenade eggs because she is uncapped here, I believe. Oh, maybe not.
Have we got any more tricks left? Ah, yes, the minions. There he goes. Go get them, doofus.
Dude, I'm not even gonna let you.
Oh, where did you come from? Why are you way over here?
Okay, 15 left.
Aha, of course. Why didn't I think of this earlier? Release the toxic gas!
Oh, dude. Gladys Portal Core. Should have activated the gas at the beginning, honestly. You're right. What a mistake. One more.
Okay, numbskulls, time for the biggest, baddest spell I can muster. Prepare to join your buddy Bottles. You'll wish you'd never taken the mighty Gruntilda Winky Bunion.
Winky Bunion? Is that your last name?
No! Of course not! But don't you go telling anyone or I'll sue you!
Whatever you say, Winky.
Now die! Oh, shit! That dude hurt!
I'm sorry, I'm hitting you and it's doing nothing? How many hits do I take?
How many hits are you taking? What?
I'm pretty sure that I need to hit her with an egg while her power is above her head, but how do I do that? There we go. She was shooting those damn fast.
Oh, the smell! I've dropped it! Quick! Somebody get rid of it before it... Ooh!
Well, we sure sold old Winky Bunyan again, eh, Banjo?
Yep, we certainly did.
Come on, let's get down to bottles for that party.
Good idea.
Well done, Banjo and Kazooie! Woo! Woo! Oh.
It seems a bit quiet for a party.
Hey, Bottle Boy! Where's this party?
It's finished, I'm afraid. Oh boy. That Klungo sure was hungry. He's eaten everything in the house!
Ugh. Mumbo wanted to boogie.
Look at him go. He's doing a little groove. Big heat bummer. It's all your fault, Bird Brain. You should have dealt with the bony crone quicker. Wow, rude. Why didn't you go? At least I wasn't hiding in my silos like a coward. Why, you feathered...
Useless Humba hid in wigwam, too.
Shut up, or Wumba turned stupid shaman into frog.
Me summon gold statue to kick ugly Wumba's butt.
Oh, stop it, all of you. You can go outside if you want to argue.
Kazooie's got a better idea.
Yeah. Does anyone fancy a kick around? I don't even know what they mean by that. Kick around? Sure. Kick around? What's that, punk?
Follow us and find out.
Greatest part of the game right here. There they go. Dude, sucks about the party, though. Feel like we missed out. Ha! We shook her head off! This is so funny. Take that, witch!
Oh, this much fun.
Mumbo, right. Big heap fun. I love how they argue and then they're all like, they're bonding over kicking Grunty's disembodied head. It is great that everyone gets to participate in kicking Grunty around. Oh! Ew.
Oh, I think her eye just fell out.
You'll be sorry, all of you! Just you wait until Banjo-Threeie! She said it in this version! She doesn't even say just wait until Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. There was an opportunity to change that to say Nuts and Bolts. They didn't! Maybe Banjo-Threeie is still real! There's still hope! Banjo-Threeie! All right, that's it. Once again, I'm Josh Jepson. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. Thank you to those of you who support on Patreon, by the way. I appreciate all of you. I guess we'll see you in the next one. Whatever that may be. Have a good one, everybody. Thank you.